Good evening, dear students. Welcome back to Tenali Parshala. As you know, I have started Sudarshan series for second PU chemistry up to NEET level. Already I uploaded 4 videos. If you have not seen that, the link is given in the description. Now in today's class, we are going to talk about preparation of haloalkanes. Yes, without wasting time, let us start with preparation of haloalkanes can be done by many methods. In that, first method is from alcohols. Okay, alcohols general formula, you know, I think so. ROH, general formula for alcohols. So from alcohols, again 3 sub methods are there: using halogen acid, using thionyl chloride, using phosphorus halide. Those things we are going to discuss in this class up to NEET level. Yes, let us start with from alcohols by using halogen acid. What is the alcohol general formula? ROH. What is general formula of halogen acid? Halogen acid means hydrogen halide. What is general formula, guys? HX. Okay, when you treat alcohol with HX, what you are expecting? Simple concept, H2 is eliminated. What is eliminated? H2O, and we will get haloalkane, RX plus H2O. This is our haloalkane, or commonly called as alkyl halide also. Getting? So, when alcohol is treated with halogen acid means hydrogen halide, you will get haloalkane plus water, dehydration takes place. Sir, what is the mechanism? Mechanism is, carefully see, this mechanism is very important for competitive purpose, not for board. For board, this mechanism is not there, but for competitive, it is required. See, first you take alcohol. You know that alcohol is having lone pair on the oxygen. Now, HX means, is it an acid? It may be HCl, it may be HBr, it may be HI. Is it an acid? Yes, it is. It will donate a proton. So you take a proton from the acid. So let us say it is a HX. So halogen is more electronegative than hydrogen. Therefore, these electrons are taken by halogen. And you know, in organic chemistry, one who takes electron gets negative and one who donates electron gets positive. So hydrogen is getting plus and halogen is getting minus. So 100% these lone pairs are going to attack on hydrogen. Now what is I? You are getting, you check it, ROHH. What you are having? ROHH. And oxygen is having plus charge. Sir, why oxygen is having plus charge? Because oxygen is donating its electron to hydrogen. And you know, in organic chemistry, one who donates electron gets a plus, one who accepts electron gets a minus. So here oxygen is donating, therefore oxygen plus, hydrogen is accepting plus, and that minus will be neutral. Therefore, hydrogen is not having any sign. Next step, what happens? Carefully see. This oxygen is already having 3 bonds, which is highly unstable. So, what to do? It will take the electron from the neighboring carbon. R means any alkyl group, you know that. It may be CH3, C2H5, C3H7, whatever. Okay. So, what is left over? It tell me R plus plus HHO. Means what is there? H2O is eliminated. What is R plus? It is a carbocation. Carbocation. So carbocation is formed, means what you have to do? If possible, you have to go for rearrangement. Very important. We'll discuss that. What is rearrangement? I hope you are getting. First, hydrogen is taken from the oxygen and it will form H2O, OH2 plus. So that oxygen will take the electron from the neighboring carbon, creating carbocation. So if carbocation is there, if possible, rearrangement, you go for rearrangement. If possible, you go for rearrangement. What is rearrangement? We'll discuss that. Okay. So remember that point. Now you are having carbocation, right? So next step, this carbocation is going to attack by halogen. X minus is there, no, that one. Here X minus is eliminated. That X minus is attacking. Next step, it is going to attack and it is going to form RX. I hope you are getting. So in the entire mechanism, what you are observing, you are getting carbocation intermediate. So you are getting carbocation intermediate means you can go for rearrangement. So what is rearrangement? We'll discuss so many examples so that this should be clear to you guys. How they are going to ask in NEET, we'll discuss that. Just you take a screenshot of it. Yes. I hope you have taken a screenshot. Now we'll talk about the examples. how they are going to ask in NEET based on this concept, how they are going to ask the question, right? We'll discuss that, what is rearrangement by now. Yes guys, so what is that rearrangement, what type of question they are going to ask in NEET? Just you see the concept. Suppose this is a question given to you. You know the first PU bond line formula, right? So that is only methylpropbute. Butane is there. Second position alcohol. Third position methyl group is there, right? So what you are expecting? Just you replace OH by Cl. 100% wrong. Why direct elimination of OH by Cl is not possible? Because here rearrangement is going to take place. That only I told. Carbocation formation. If possible, go for rearrangement. What is that? Check it. See. First step, what you are expecting? This H plus is there now. That is taken by OH. Correct? So what you are expecting? You are going to get like this. Here OH2 plus. So as a result, these electrons are taken by oxygen. So what you will get? You will get like this. Plus charge on carbon. And this carbon is having two substituents. Therefore, it is secondary carbocation. Carefully observe the neighboring carbon. Here 1, 2, 3... substituents are there, 1H is there. So this is a tertiary carbocation. And you know that secondary carbocation is more stable or tertiary carbocation is more stable? Tertiary carbocation is more stable. Therefore, in this case, hydride shift takes place. Hydride means this H is going to attack here. So what you will be expecting? Carefully see. This H is taken by this carbon, means this carbon positive charge is suppressed. So positive charge is created here. So as a result here. So this carbocation is a tertiary. So on what basis you are telling, sir? See, this carbon is having 1, 2, 3. 3 substituents. If 3 substituents are there on the carbon, that carbon containing positive charge is called a tertiary carbocation. Which is more stable? Now you can attack it. This is called what? This is 1, 2. 1, 2 hydride shift it is. Hydride shift. Why it is shifting? To make a stable carbocation. Getting my point? That only I told. If possible, go for rearrangement. Getting my point? So are the halogens? Halogen is nothing but Cl minus we have taken. So that Cl minus is going to attack here. So finally what you are expecting the answer? Answer is this position Cl. So if you are going for direct method, this position you will get Cl. That is wrong. Why? Because rearrangement. Getting my point? So rearrangement means if neighboring carbon is having a tertiary, then you can go for rearrangement to make it stable. Getting? So one more example I'll give. You just try it yourself and then go see the further video. See guys, what is the first step? First step, obviously this OH is there, it is going to take the H plus. Cl minus is eliminated. Correct? So what is the product you are expecting? As it is, here OH2 you will get. Yes. CH3. C, CH3, CH3, CH, CH3 and here OH2 plus you are having. Correct? Next step, dehydration. Water will be eliminating minus H2O. What you are expecting? CH3, C, CH3, CH3. Here what is there? CH. This side, CH3. And this electron is taken by oxygen. Therefore, oxygen plus sign, this minus suppressed. H2O is eliminated. What is remaining? This carbon is donating electron. Therefore, this carbon gets a plus charge. Because that carbon is donating electron. You remember this point in organic chemistry. One who donate electron gets a plus. One who accept electron gets a minus. Now carefully see. This carbon is having two substituent. This carbon is having two substituent. So it is a secondary carbocation. Correct or not? You see the neighboring carbon guys. Neighboring carbon, it is having 3-4 substituent. So if you shift this methyl, it becomes a tertiary carbocation. Now tell me, secondary carbocation is more stable or tertiary carbocation is more stable? Tertiary. Therefore, methyl shift can be taking place. So what you are expecting? Carefully see, this is going to attack here. As a result, this carbon is losing electron. And this methyl group is going to attach here. So 1-2, it is called 1-2 methyl shift, because methyl is going to shift from this carbon to this carbon. What this is called? 1-2 methyl shift. 1-2 methyl shift. What you are expecting? Carefully see. CH3. Yes. C, CH3. Here, CH, here CH3 as it is. This methyl group is attached from this carbon to this carbon. So here CH3 is attached. What about this carbon? This carbon loses the electron. Therefore that carbon gets a plus charge. Now carefully see this carbocation, guys. This carbon is having 1, 2, 3. 3 substituent. Therefore it is a tertiary carbocation. It is a tertiary carbocation. What is the last step? Attack of halogen. Which halogen we have taken? Cl. So Cl is going to attack on this carbon. You will get the answer. So what is happening next step? Cl minus is going to attack on this carbon. Getting? So final answer is, as it is everything, here Cl is attached. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon. CH3, C, CH3, CH, CH3. Here what is there? CH3. And this carbon you are having Cl. You add here Cl. So this is the product. Getting my point. So if you go for direct method, you would have been added Cl here only. Getting my point. So this concept, it is not a direct method. We have to see the rearrangement. When you have to see the rearrangement, if it is possible. So how do you know that either it is going to go for rearrangement or not? It depends upon the neighboring carbon where the OH group is attached. If OH group attached containing carbon to that neighboring carbon is having tertiary group, 100% rearrangement is going to take place. Either it is hydride shift or methyl shift. It depends upon the compound given to you. Getting? One more example I will give you. That is what, if cyclic ring is there, then what to do, sir? Sir, what you are telling? Simply in NCERT we have studied ROH plus HX. We got RX plus H2 and you are telling this much. This is needed for NEET, guys. Getting my point? Yes, we'll discuss that one more problem. So that cyclic ring is there, then what to do? Carefully see. Now carefully see, guys, if this cyclic ring is there, this are the kind of pentyl ring, cyclopentyl, okay. Now again, same thing, carefully see, this is having lone pair of electron. First step, it is going to attack on H plus and Cl minus, right? Cl minus is eliminated. H plus is taken by OH. So what you are expecting? Clearly you are expecting like this. Here, OH2 plus, correct? So these electrons are taken by oxygen. The electrons are taken by oxygen. As a result, this carbon is donating electron. Therefore, this carbon gets a plus charge. What is the next step you will get? This carbon is having plus charge. Then what is happening? Actually, H2 is eliminated. H2 is eliminated. Now, carefully see, here halogen is not attacked. Because this is a 5-membered ring. It is a C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 5-membered ring, there is a ring strain. So what to do? Ring expansion takes place. See, in earlier two example, shifting of hydrogen, shifting of methyl takes place. Here, ring expansion. So depending upon the compound, you are getting different rearrangement. Getting my point? Ring expansion means a 5-membered ring is there, no? That becomes a 6-membered ring. Carefully see. This is going to taken by this carbon and this carbon is going to attack here. As a result, what is happening? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 membered is there. One more carbon is added. So you will get a 6-membered ring like this. And positive charge on it. 6-membered ring. Carefully see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And above one, 6. Total 6-membered ring. So why 6-membered ring is going to happen? Because 5-membered ring, there is a ring strain. 6-membered ring, that is more stable. So clearly we got 6-membered ring. Now halogen is eliminated, right, in the first step. That halogen is going to attack here. So finally what you will get? You will get like this. Chlorocyclohexane. Chlorocyclohexane you will get. I hope you are getting. So this is regarding first part. From alcohols, in that first one, using halogen acid or hydrogen halide also you can call it as. Halogen acid or hydrogen halide. Now you have to remember some points during this reaction. What are the points you have to remember? That I will write on the board. Just go on copying it, guys. Because you have to make the notes. Then only it is helpful to you. Okay. Yes, if you want to take a screenshot, you can take it. Just I will rub and I will write the important points which are necessary for NEET and JEE. And KCET also. Yes. See, guys. What are the important points to be remembered for competitive from this concept. Or see, this reaction involves carbocation formation. Therefore, if possible go for rearrangement. So what is the rearrangement? Everything we have studied now. Sometime hydride shift, sometime methyl shift, sometime ring expansion. Ring expansion means increase in the number of the members in the ring. Everything we have studied with an example. I hope it is clear to you. If you are not getting, please see the video once. Definitely will get. Okay. So carbocation formed. If possible, go for rearrangement. This is the first point you have to remember. Now what is the order of reactivity of alcohols? Means you have taken alcohols, right? For which alcohol it is going to be faster? Which alcohol the reaction is to be slower? Because here carbocation formation takes place, the alcohol which will form tertiary carbocation, that will be more faster, right? So which is a tertiary carbocation forming alcohol? That is tertiary alcohol. So always remember, tertiary alcohol is having more faster reaction than secondary, than primary. For this one means by using alcohols, using halogen acid. Getting? Why tertiary is more faster? Because tertiary alcohol will form tertiary carbocation, and which is more stable. Therefore, tertiary is greater than secondary, is greater than primary. This is order of reactivity of alcohols. Next point is order of reactivity of halogen acid, HX, or hydrogen halide also you can call it. Halogen acid. So what is the order, guys? HI is more faster than HBr, than HCl. Means if you are using HX now, where HI is greater than HBr is greater than HCl. Why, sir? Because in HI, the bond dissociation energy is very less. Meaning is, I is a larger size, so H is a smaller size, so easily this bond can be broken. So what? If the bond can be easily broken, means we want H plus, right? So it will give H plus easily compared to others. Getting my point? Therefore, HI is more reactive towards this reaction than HBr, than HCl. And you study, the reaction is ROH plus HX give rise to RX plus H2O. If you use HCl and zinc chloride, that process is called as Grew's process. See here, very important. Grew's process. So what is Grew's process? Same reaction. See, ROH you are taking, HX you are taking, no, in place of HX you have to take HCl. And what is the catalyst used here? ZnCl2. Anhydrous ZnCl2. What happens? Simply again same. H2 is eliminated. RCl we are getting. RCl plus H2O. So here you are using HCl and zinc chloride. Therefore the name of the process is Grew's process. Particularly talking about chlorine. Getting my point? And mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride. Very important this point also. Mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride is called as Lucas reagent. Lucas reagent. Very important. Sometimes they will ask in board for one mark. What is Lucas reagent? Sorry. Mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride is called as Lucas reagent. You are going to learn regarding Lucas test in next chapter. That is alcohol, phenols and ether. Just I will give a glance. Lucas test is used to distinguish the alcohols. Tertiary alcohol gives immediate turbidity with Lucas reagent. Secondary alcohol gives turbidity after 5 minutes. Primary alcohol will not give turbidity in cold condition. We have to give heat to it. So after heating it will give turbidity. So in this way we can separate the primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols by Lucas test, by Lucas reagent. That we are going to study in detail in the alcohol, phenols, ether chapter, next chapter. We'll discuss there better, right? So as of now you remember, Lucas reagent is a mixture of concentrated HCl and zinc chloride. Getting my point? Yes. And very important point, carefully see. If you want RBR means alkyl bromide, so better you use H2SO4. Meaning is, carefully see, to get bromo alkanes, use sulfuric acid. What you have to use? Sulfuric acid. And to get iodoalkane, use phosphoric acid. Use H3PO4, phosphoric acid. What is the meaning, sir? Meaning is, you see, if you want ROH and if you are using HBr, what you have to use here? H2SO4. And if you want to take for iodine, HI, you use here H3PO4. So that the reaction becomes faster. So what happens? Again, same. H2 is eliminated. RBr plus H2. And if you want HI, again, same. Ri plus H2O. Now question arises, sir, is it necessary to use H3PO4? Why not H2SO4 here also? Because, see, HI is there, no? HI is a reducing agent and H2SO4 is a oxidizing agent. And if you use HI and H2SO4 may oxidize the HI. Therefore, instead of H2SO4, we have to use H3PO4 if you are taking HI. Sir, if you are not using, only you will take alcohol plus HX, that is fine. No doubt you will get the product. But in this case, you will get high yield. Getting my point? Yes. So this is the first method. So these are the important points you have to remember here. Getting? If you want, you can take a screenshot. Yes, guys. Next method is from alcohols only by using thionyl chloride. Sir, what is thionyl chloride? Thia is a nickname for sulfur, guys. So thionyl chloride means SOCl2. Same thing from alcohols only, but using thionyl chloride. Meaning is, you take ROH, add SOCl2. What we have to add? SOCl2. In presence of pyridine. What happens? So simply RCl is formed. RCl plus SO2, that is in gas form, plus HCl, that is also in gas form. So what is happening, sir? Actually, carefully see, you take ROH and you take SOCl2. How you have to add SOCl2? Carefully see in this fashion. So what is happening? Break the bonds like this. So what you are getting? RCl, SO2, HCl, you are getting. And this method is very good method to prepare the haloalkane, because the byproducts are, both the byproducts are in gas form, easily went out. So you will get a pure and good yield. Getting my point? And this process of preparation of haloalkane from alcohol using thionyl chloride is known as Darzan's process. What it is known as? Darzan's process. This process of preparation of haloalkane is called as Darzan's process. Then what is Darzan's process, sir? When alcohol treated with thionyl chloride in the presence of pyridine gives a haloalkane with elimination of SO2 and HCl gas. This process of preparation of haloalkane is called Darzan's process. Okay. Sir, why it is very best method to remaining all compared to remaining all other methods? Because here byproducts are gases in nature. Getting my point? Now question arises, sir, what is the role of pyridine here? Pyridine is used to neutralize the HCl formed during the reaction. And very important point, this reaction is proceed via SN2 mechanism. There also pyridine is required. Getting my point? So this is regarding using thionyl chloride. Any example you can take, guys, any example, either it is primary alcohol or secondary alcohol or tertiary alcohol. Here no carbocation formation, no rearrangement. No rearrangement means, remember this point, no rearrangement. So if no rearrangement means direct product only will get. So if you take a primary alcohol like this, or you can take a tertiary alcohol like this, or you can take a cyclic alcohol like this. So all the examples I will give. See what you can add? You can add HCl, sorry. Talking about SOCl2 in presence of pyridine, SOCl2 in presence of fielding. SOCl2 in presence of fielding. This is fixed. So in all the case, what you are expecting? This O and this SO. Eliminate as a SO2 plus HCl. Those are the byproduct. Only replace OH by Cl. What you will get? Remaining everything is same. So earlier case we went for rearrangement. Here no rearrangement. What you have written? No rearrangement. No carbocation formation. Wherever OH is there, you replace the OH by Cl. Clear it is. So what you do? Here also OH is replaced by. Here I have taken tertiary. OH is replaced by Cl as it is. Whatever may be the neighboring carbon, OH attached carbon containing carbon may be primary, secondary, tertiary, cyclic. It doesn't matter. Because here no rearrangement. In earlier case there may be a new rearrangement. Here no rearrangement. Wherever OH is there, replaced by Cl. Simple concept. Here also OH is attached to this carbon, right? So you replace OH by Cl. You will get the answer. Here carbon is there, to that Cl. In place of OH you added Cl. Simple concept. Sorry, here also you have to add Cl, not OH. OH is replaced by Cl. Getting my point? So these are some examples and regarding this method. Now we have to talk about what are the important points which you have to remember during this process. Is carefully see important points. So these points are very important for NEET guys. So you just go on noting it. First point: reaction follows SN2 mechanism. Very important. This thiophilic chloride reaction follows SN2 mechanism. Therefore, there is no rearrangement, direct attack. So you know already. We'll study that. What is SN2 mechanism? What is SN1 mechanism in further chapter, part of the chapter, right? So as of now, you remember SN2 means Baxter attack takes place. So as a result, if OH is attached to chiral carbon, sometimes you are having Walden inversion. Inversion means, we'll discuss that in further part of the chapter. It is there. We'll talk about optical activity, what is chiral carbon, everything we'll talk about. Just you go on noting now. So if OH is attached to chiral carbon, then inversion also called as Walden inversion takes place. Sir, what is the meaning, sir? Whenever OH is attached to chiral carbon, sir, what is chiral carbon? Carbon having four different groups attached to it. Okay, and such a case, if OH is attached, that OH is replaced by Cl, but in reverse fashion. Means OH is attached to the front side, then obviously that OH is replaced by Cl, but Cl is going to attack at the back side. If OH is attached at the back side, Cl will going to attack at the front side. That is called inversion. We'll discuss in detail regarding inversion, retention and racemization, everything in the further part of the chapter. As of now, you remember like this. So when this is possible, when OH is attached to a chiral carbon, then inversion can be possible. Getting my point? And very importantly, here you have taken thionyl chloride. Sir, why you have taken thionyl chloride only? Why not thionyl bromide and thionyl iodide? SOBr2, SOI2 can be prepared from this method. RBr and RI never be possible. Why, sir? Carefully see. RI and RBr. And RI and RBr can't be prepared by this method. Can't be prepared from this method. This method. Because what is the reason, sir? What is the reason? Reason is because here you want SOBr2, right? SOBr2 is unstable. SOBr2 is unstable. And SOI2 doesn't exist. It does not exist only. So how can you use it? Getting or not? Only halo chloro alkanes can be prepared from this. Means alkyl chloride only prepared from this. Alkyl bromide and alkyl iodide can't be prepared by this method, because our SOBr2 and SOI2 is unstable. SOI2 does not exist only. So therefore, we can prepare only chloroalkane or alkyl chloride from this method. So these are the important points regarding this second method, from alcohols only, but using from alcohols using thiolyl chloride. Remember, thia is a nickname for sulfur. Thiolyl chloride means, you remember the formula, SOCl2. Clear? So if you want to take a screenshot, you can take it. We'll talk about the third reaction and we'll complete the today's lecture. Okay, let's take a screenshot. I hope you have taken the screenshot. Now we'll talk about the third method. Carefully see, guys. So this is the third method, from alcohols only, but using phosphorus halide. Again, there are two cases: phosphorus trihalide, phosphorus pentahalide. Look at the name. Trihalide means three halogen atoms are there. Pentahalide means five halogen atoms are there. In both cases, you will get haloalkanes only. Direct method you will get, wherever OH is there, replaced by halogen. But what is the point you have to remember here is, so here the byproducts are different, here the byproducts are different. Yes, let us start with that. First, we'll talk about PX3. How it is PX3 is prepared? Remember this point. You take red phosphorus plus X2 halogen, you will get PX3. Remember this point. Means how PX3 is prepared. Sometime instead of PX3, they will give red phosphorus and X2. Both are same. Yes, let us start with, you take an alcohol, we are talking about alcohol only, and add phosphorus trihalide, nothing but PX3. So what you are expecting? You have to take three molecules here, remember. So what happens? You will get RX plus H3PO3 is called phosphorus acid. What it is called? Phosphorus acid. And its basicity is equal to 2. Always remember, regarding phosphorus acid, H3PO4 is phosphoric acid, H3PO3 is a phosphorus acid. This is a byproduct. So how we are getting this? Carefully see, three molecules of alcohol you write. Simple method to remember. Three molecules of alcohol I have written. Okay, sir. PX3, how it looks like? X, X, and X. Carefully see, this is happening. H3PO3. That is phosphorus acid. Now what is remaining? RRR, XXX. So three molecules of RX. I hope this is interesting to you guys, right? So in place of R, you can write any example. CH3, C2H5, any secondary alcohol. You can take tertiary alcohol, whatever may be the nature of the alcohol. Just OH is replaced by halogen. It may be Cl or Br or iodine. Anyone you can prepare from this method. Getting my point. So what about this with phosphorus pentachloride, sir? Pentahalide. Again, same only, but byproducts are different. Carefully see. So what do you have to take again? ROH plus phosphorus pentahalide, PX5. So what you are expecting? Simply, this R will take one of the X. So it is forming RX. POX3 is formed. POX3. Now remaining is one H and one X. HX. This is called phosphorus oxyhalide. What it is called? Phosphorus oxyhalide. Means POCl3 is there, phosphorus oxychloride. POBr3 is there, phosphorus oxybromide, like that. What is RX? Our haloalkane. We are preparing that only. RX means haloalkane or alkyl halide. And HX means anything. It is a halogen acid. HCl, hydrochloric acid. HBr, hydrobromic acid, right? Hydrogen bromide also you can call it, correct or not? Yes. Sir, what is actually happening here? How to remember this? Carefully see. You take ROH. Okay. Write up PX3 in such a fashion that you should get like this. Carefully see. Five halogens are there. No, I will write three halogens here, one halogen here, and one halogen here. Now cut the bond like this. See what you are having? RX. Are you getting RX? Yes. POX3. What is remaining? HX. Are you getting HX? Yes. This is a simple way to remember that. Getting my point? So if you want any example, in place of R, you can put CH3 or C2H5 or anything, secondary alcohol also you can put it. But here both the methods are very important. You remember this point. Both methods are direct methods only. Both methods are direct methods. Direct methods means are what? So directly OH is replaced by halogen. Wherever OH is attached, you just remove OH, add halogen. Directly you will get in competitive exam. Getting? And no rearrangement. No rearrangement. You remember this point too. Only in case of preparation of haloalkane from alcohol using HX, first method, using hydrogen halide or halogen acid. There only you will get rearrangement. Remaining all case, there is no rearrangement. Here also no rearrangement. Here also no rearrangement. I hope you are getting. We'll solve some examples on this, some problems, and then today's class will be going to be completed. Okay. Yes, let us see. See guys, these are the examples using phosphorus halides only. Either phosphorus trichloride or phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus trihalide or phosphorus pentahalides. Always remember, no rearrangement, direct method only. OH is replaced by halogen. Okay, only in case of hydrogen halide there is a rearrangement. Okay, yes, check it. First case, OH is attached here, just Cl is added to here. So what is the answer you will get? You will get like this, here Cl. And phosphorus trichloride is there. What is the byproduct? H3PO3. And we also add here 3. Here also 3. 3 molecules you will get. So second case also you see. Here I used phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus pentachloride means again same. OH is replaced by Cl. Wherever OH is there, you just remove OH. Add one Cl. Everything is same. Yes, write down. CH3CH and here ClCH3. What is the byproducts you are getting? PO Cl3 and HCl. What are the byproduct? POCl3 plus HCl. Correct. What about next case? Again same. You add anything here. PCl3 or PCl5. Again OH is replaced by Cl. Everything is same. Because there is no rearrangement. And what is the byproduct? Byproduct is H3PO3. Phosphorus acid. Always remember, whenever you are using phosphorus trichloride or phosphorus trihalide, phosphorus acid is a byproduct, H3PO3. And whenever you are using phosphorus pentachloride, the byproducts are phosphorus oxyhalide and HCl. POCl3 and HCl. I hope you are getting, guys, right? So next one, you see, carefully see. Don't worry about the substituent given to us. You just replace OH by Cl. So what you are getting, you check it. Are we getting like this? Everything is same. Just to make you confused, they are given like this. So Cl3, what is the byproduct? H3PO3, phosphorus acid. So in last case, carefully observe. Same example I have taken, but see guys, in last question, HCl is given. Means sometimes you can go for rearrangement. Correct or not? Carefully see, this oxygen is going to attack on H+, and Cl- is eliminated. This H is taken by oxygen. So what you are getting in the first step? Here as it is, benzene, and here OH2+. What you are having here? OH2+. Next step, this OH is taken by the oxygen. As a result, you will get like this. Here as it is, here plus charge. Carefully see, this is a secondary carbocation. This is our secondary carbocation, and neighboring is a tertiary. So you can go for hydride shift. Here H is there, let us say. This H is going to attack here. Sir, H, where, from where that H came? Carefully see, this carbon is having 1, 2, 3 bonds. And you know, carbon should have 4 bonds. So, 3 bonds are shown. 1 bond is not shown. Means 100% it is a hydrogen is present. Usually, hydrogens are not shown in the bond line diagram. First PO, first organic chapter, right? So, carefully see, this H is going to shift here. So, what you are getting actually? You are going to get like this. Here positive charge is created and this is a tertiary carbocation. Now halogen is eliminated to here Cl minus. That Cl minus is going to attack here. Cl minus is going to attack. So finally what you will get? Finally you will get like this. Here only Cl is attached. See the difference between fourth one and fifth one, guys. In fourth one, wherever OH is there only Cl you are getting. So in fifth one, OH is there here, but Cl you are getting at this position. That is due to a rearrangement. What is the main reason here? Rearrangement. Correct? Because HCl is present, carbocation formation may be possible. I hope you understood. If you want to take a screenshot, you can take it. So I hope you have taken this screenshot also. So this is regarding preparation of haloalkanes from alcohol. That is the first method. From alcohol, three methods we have discussed. Using halogen acid HX, there is a rearrangement, carbocation formation. You remember those points. Okay. Yes. Second one, using thionyl chloride. From alcohols only, but using thionyl chloride, SOCl2. And third method, using phosphorus halide. Again, two methods in case. PX3 and PX5. PX3 byproduct is phosphorus acid. PX5 byproducts are HCl and, PX5, the byproducts are POX3 and HX. Correct or not? So, this is regarding preparation of haloalkane from alcohols. First method. Now, in the next class, we are going to discuss about preparation of haloalkane from alkane, from alkene, and last one, halogen exchange. They are very important question. Finkelstein and Swartz reaction we will discuss in the next class. So, thanks for watching. If you are not getting anything, just please see the video once, definitely you will get. And if you are getting